Hello, everyone. Thanks for tuning in to this weather briefing, where I will discuss the weather outlook through a portion of the holiday season, including the showers and winds we will get Saturday night, and then the possibility of a significant storm for Christmas. I'm Stephen Harrison, meteorologist. A weak ridge of high pressure will produce some warming and fair skies through Friday. Then a cold front will move through the region late Saturday, bringing widespread clouds, showers, and some stronger west winds. Current forecast rainfall amounts for this system look to be light to locally moderate. This graphic shows the current forecast precipitation totals for late Saturday through very early Sunday. Highest amounts are expected over the mountains. Snow levels will drop to 5,000 to 5,500 feet, with a trace to a few inches of snow possible above those elevations in the mountains. Looking ahead to late next week, including Christmas, there are signs that we could see a significant storm drop down over the area, but details are still sketchy and confidence remains low at the moment. Nevertheless, stay tuned for more updates on this potential storm. As far as temperatures go for Christmas Eve and beyond, there are indications that there will be below normal temperatures throughout the West, with above normal temperatures in the central to eastern U.S. So if you're visiting family and friends in those areas, your chances of seeing a white Christmas could be low. For the quick-hitting storm system this weekend, we may start to see some showers as early as Saturday afternoon, with the most widespread shower activity occurring Saturday evening into late Saturday night. Showers will quickly end Sunday morning. Most of the precipitation accumulations will occur over and west of the mountains and in the high deserts, with perhaps some sprinkles or isolated light showers in the lower deserts. Some strong west winds gusting to 50 miles per hour and locally higher in the windiest spots will be possible as well in the mountains and deserts, resulting in hazardous conditions for high-profile vehicles, including Interstates 8, 10, and 15. Northwest winds could be strong enough over the coastal waters to be hazardous to small craft. And as mentioned earlier, we're keeping an eye on the potential for a storm system occurring around the Christmas holiday. That's the end of this briefing. Thanks for watching and have a happy and safe holiday season.